My lab researches gastric and pancreatic cancer, and in particular, we're very interested in identifying the interactions between the cancer cells and the patient's immune cells within that tumor microenvironment.
Helicobacter is a bacteria that can colonize the stomach and it triggers an inflammatory response. So it's this collaboration and crosstalk between the immune system and the epithelial cells that eventually become cancer. So the problem is that patients will not show symptoms of sometimes the Helicobacter infection, but more importantly, the changes to the mucosa that precede gastric cancer. At this point in time, the only way we can determine that is by doing an endoscopy and then getting biopsies and having the pathologists take a look at that. The objective was to identify molecules that would indicate that there is a problem going on in the stomach that would eventually turn into cancer. You have to start somewhere, and we many times will start in the model organisms and then start to think about translation. We then collect patient samples to see if mouse models actually translate to humans. In this case, it's definitely translating.
So we obtain the tumor tissue from the patient, and the cells are then embedded into a matrix referred to as matrigel, and that allows the cells to form this three-dimensional structure similar to what you would see in the patient's own tumor.
The microRNA that we discovered in this study would be a way of using the blood sample to say, oh, there is this change already going on in the stomach, and make the decision that way whether to go on and do the endoscopy or not.
With many GI cancers, the patient will not respond well to immunotherapy. When you have different GI cancers, if you have pancreatic, colon, and gastric, the underlying mechanism by which a patient may not respond well in gastric cancer may be applicable to pancreatic cancer.
This cell type, called a myeloid-derived suppressor cell, does show up in pancreatic cancer, can show up in colon cancer, liver cancer.
We want to reprogram the cancer cells or the immune cells within that patient's tumor environment to make the patient more responsive to the therapy that they're receiving.
The tricky part is you need a large number of people to actually look to see whether we consistently pick up the signature and whether it correlates with what we would see in the stomach. If we can look at a large number of patients where we already know what the changes are and then we correlate it with what's in the blood, then we can make decisions before bringing people in for more invasive procedures.